Darko! What's going on?
They are breaking in! They fought me!
Just hang on! I'm on my way!
Don't be stupid. It was only a matter of time.
Shit.
And we're back. Now, in the cutscene there, you could see the wreckage of the ship behind us, but apparently it's disappeared since... Ah, well. Just behind this truck, we got a couple items to grab. And inside this box, there's a smaller variety of ammo box. I never really specify there's a difference. These are the kind that usually don't have any ammo for us, as you can see. Now, there's a black market up here, and I am going to pop into it, but I'm not going to bother showing it. All I did was slap a firepower upgrade into the VX. It helps me take guys out in one shot. Doesn't make a huge difference, but it's nice. Anyways, grabbing the accuracy upgrade out of there is a good idea because it will spawn the enemies sooner than we really want. Now, if you look around, you might recognize this place. Now, from the perspective, it's a little confusing, this black goo, and it's night. If you remember back to right after we got the power throw, that was that long walkway we had to head up into this area. See, if you look over there, you can see that machine gun nest, except there's no machine gun. Oh, wait. There it is. Thank you, Poppin. We've got a new enemy type. These guys are stingers. They are dicks. As you can see, they have ranged attacks. This is not good, because they have the equivalent of shotguns, and they hurt. They can also take quite a beating, as you can see. New enemies, though, means new finishers. Oh yes, ultraviolence. Never change, Dark Sector. Never change. Unfortunately, they're also quite a bit tougher, and they have a tendency to sort of vary between offensive, ranged, and melee attacks, so they can be a bit tricky to keep track of. As you can see, one of them just came behind us. Shields, however, are great, because ranged attacks can be reflected. But in addition to the new enemy types, we've also got an old enemy type with an upgrade. This is a howler. It doesn't look like one, but they've apparently progressed in their mutation, just like us. All the abilities are pretty much the same. They do smash us, they grab us, we finish them in the exact same way. They have a couple of differences. The main one is that they do more damage, and they take more damage. A single power throw is no longer enough to kill them. And here, like I was saying, are bigger ammo boxes. These are the much more valuable ones, and the ones you should keep your eye out for. Of course, it's impossible to tell since they all come in the same stupid boxes before you open them, but if you have the luxury of time, it's not always worth it to grab the little ones if you're kind of an ammo hog like I am. Now, in the black market, because this is a new chapter, there was in fact a new gun. However, I didn't want to purchase it because I didn't have these Enferon shells. And without the Enferon shells, replacing the Vekesk would have been a bad idea. This level is full of infected, and not having Enferon would have sucked. So even though the new weapon is much better, I had to wait for Enferon shells. And of course, because the Enferon shells were in this room, I can't go back. So we'll have to wait until the next level to see a black mark. Now we got black goo up ahead. We'll have to get fire somehow to get through it. But there's a conveniently shiny pipe. Hooray! Water overheats the generator. We don't want the electricity. We're waiting for fire. Pretty simple all in all. I was getting a bit... Yeah, I was hoping to keep the fire long enough to hit that guy, but it was going out and I panicked. I don't think the energy pulse would have hit him if I'd waited anyway. Rather, I wouldn't have had fire for the energy pulse.
Oh, my God.
tell you what I mean about the unfrozen gas. Stingers from above. Now, stingers, like I said, can be a bit tricky. Sometimes they'll rush in behind you and start gunning at you at close range, other times they'll run off and try to get cover. That's what I think that other guy did. You can sort of hear him growling. This area in particular has lots of nooks and crannies for them to hide in, but he doesn't appear to be down here. Well, that's not good. He hasn't taken up our position. Stingers are more than happy to get behind you. But yeah. They're supposed to come in waves of two here, but I have no idea where that guy went. And the door isn't open, and this isn't a door you get to open. It just sort of opens after a couple enemies charge through it later. You can still hear him growling, just... Oh, he never came down. Thankfully, he's not gonna move, and I can just nail him, so... even have time to reload. There we go. I think it's because I took a shot at that guy before he jumped down, the other one got nervous or something? Whatever. I'm not gonna complain. And there comes the last couple, bursting through the door. Stingers bursting into the windows, but you're not getting away from me that easily. Now, a power throw can kill them, depending on where you hit them, just not always, and they are fairly agile, so it makes it a little bit trickier to hit them. The days of pincushion howlers is the only enemies is sadly over. That's it for this room, so let's head out into this courtyard. See any enemies, but I'm sure that will fix itself soon. Yeah. I'm not a big fan of this sort of central area. I like hanging out more around the edges. A little more control. I don't have as many elevated positions for the stingers to attack from. But as always, the shield is a hugely valuable tool in here. I also have the annoying habit of jumping huge distances. I have no idea where that guy just went. We're not really lacking for targets at the moment. I hope you like the sound of heartbeats, because a single close-range blast from a stinger is enough to put me in there. Put another upgrade of firepower into that. the X, but doesn't really seem to be pulling its weight. Stingers are still just a little bit too powerful. And some more Howler types. A lot beefier. But their metal skin is not coming in a particularly healthy-looking manner. One thing to know about the new guys is, in addition to having more health, dealing more damage, they can actually explode when they die. Now this guy was actually about to do it, but because I hit him during the animation, he went straight into a normal death animation. Now, I was a little bit puzzled here. There were only two Howlers. Usually there's a whole lot in that last group. And that's because apparently they got gummed up a little. Oh boy. That's what I mean about them suiciding. It's not fun. They hurt about as much as a shotgun blast from the Stingers does. We got one last guy who's stuck in a wall, but I'm still having a little bit of trouble transitioning to the idea that a single power throw is not enough to kill them, so.
Get off me!
I get choked for it. I'm not sure what killed him there. There was no Enferon. The blade didn't hit him. I just guess he fell over. Stingers, they just don't seem to care very much that I'm here. And that's probably why. Now, that is an elite trooper. Those guys are dicks. They've got heavy power armor, as you saw. They've got a rocket launcher, chain gun combo. Thankfully, however, for the time being, they're more interested in the Stingers, and the Stingers are more interested in them. Unlike the last time we encountered soldiers and troopers and infected in a big old fight, the Stingers actually focus more on him, which is really beneficial the first time you meet this trooper, for a reason I'll get into in a little bit. There's one, unfortunately, because we killed that first one and then weakened a second, he didn't have that much to bother with, so we gotta deal with it ourselves. The first thing you gotta do is take out his glowing weak points. Yes, he has glowing weak points. And that's why the VX is very, very nice. Fortunately, it's not quite enough, and he has another one, you might have guessed. Yes, on his back. Now, shield is great for this. Individual throws will stun him for a moment, and that'll give you a chance to power throw. It doesn't take a lot, though, and then you can finish him off by reaching in to crush his head. Give me that gun. Come on. Come on. Well, there's one Stinger left. Usually, the nice thing about this fight is that all the Stingers will focus on him and he'll focus on the Stingers. And because the Stingers are surrounding him, they'll actually take out the weak point on the back for you, meaning that fight becomes even easier. That's not always going to happen, though, so it's a good idea to be reasonably capable of getting behind him. It's not too hard. He's a pretty slow turner, and shield is a huge boon on this. So, anyways, two things we need to go back up here for. First of all, on the other side of that bench, there's an upgrade. Stopping power. Oh boy. And, just like that first jackal fight, his ruined corpse gives us a nice little benefit, which we need to get out of this level. Fortunately, I killed him far on the other side, so I gotta book it and make sure I get there in time. But that's actually it for this chapter. Pretty short one, but yeah. It's a little bit of plot line stuff coming up here, so thanks for watching.
took Yargo.
I can't just leave him there. I know where he is.
Out of the question! He's probably infected already! Look, we're only a few hours out! Your orders are to hold position until I arrive!
Shit!
Order of the Red Star. So you already know how this sort of thing works.
I told you. I'm just old retired communications officer. I don't know how to get into this vault. It's nothing more than a tourist attraction for me. I just watched it on the monitors.
Don't play games. I know who you are. You are Yargo Mensik, born and raised here in Lazria, a colonel in the GRU. It was you who led the containment teams in 87. You're the only one left who can open that vault. Your daughter. She was a nurse, right? She would have treated the first ones who got sick before anyone knew what was going on.
Moscow knew it was serious very early on. I could have warned her.
But you had your orders.
Nothing I can do will bring her back. But I'll be damned if I'm going to let it happen again. Your Mesna's a fool. Anyone who thinks they can control this nightmare...
See? That's what it's about. That's why he needs you to open the vault, to control this. So I'm going to ask you one more time. And then, I'm going to start hurting you.
I'll never be part of this!
Oh, never say never. Oh, man.